Oh, hey guys, how's it going?
Hey, Perrin, you're watching Linda, a.k.a. the Gamer Gal.
As we like to call her, Linda, a.k.a. the Pop Star.
My girl.
Hey guys, so we are here at another location in Las Vegas. This is called Game. Basically, the gist of it is, from here, it's Japanese arcade cabinets only. You get to pay hourly or for a full day, and once you go in there, free play all you can. So let's go see what they have and let's go play some games.
Hey everybody, so let's just start off with an overview of the whole location and then we'll work our way to the gist of everything that's in there. So I'm just going to show you what is all inside. I'm just going to do a walkthrough. Basically, it's not only Japanese arcades, once I got in there, it is also American arcade cabinets, pinball, but they're not pinball like normal pinball, they're electronic pinball, and it's like a main machine. There's 100-something pinball arcade cabinets in there, and you can choose from by switching the buttons. You can also play home consoles. So say you can't afford a home console and you want to play a game, you go to the guy, you tell him you want to play something and he goes and gets the game, gives you the controller, sets it up, and then you can play there for as long as you want if you have an all day. I recommend an all day because I was there for a couple hours and I ran out of time. I tried all the cabinets just as an overview just to try them, but to be able to play something for a long time you would have to get an all day. And so here's just the gist of everything. It's a lot of, you know, like drumming and funny game. Like, I love this game. This game made me laugh. It cracked me up. It was an arm wrestling cabinet, and pretty much you had a Japanese character, and it was either a he or she that would be, like, aggressive, and then if they lost, they cried like a baby. I laughed hysterically. Yep, I'm a jerk. But I loved it. It was so funny. So, yeah, there's a lot of stuff that I've never seen in here before. There's a multi-cade, and they had a bunch of games that I've never seen before. Here's me drumming. I enjoyed the rhythm games. Those were fun. I just wish I could read Japanese because I hit two-player and didn't realize I hit two-player when I started playing. So it was fun, though. I kept playing and enjoyed that. So I laughed with that. Now, I will say there was something that was really cool in there. There is a shooter game, a shooter cabinet, and it's basically four players, and you can go crazy. And I loved it. I wish I had J-Love, you know, Dan, Captain, T-Belly, Die Hard, Phil, you know, I wish I had Chris here. All you guys, everybody in my crew, we all got to get together and try this, the four player, because it was just ridiculous how much you could play. See, there it is, right there. It's just so fun. And the enemies are really unique. I liked it. I couldn't read Japanese, so I can't tell you what the shooter is. Anybody who sees this, they probably can put in the comments below what it is. But basically, you can rotate back and forth your fighter. And then from there, you can keep going. The enemies look like Gradius, kind of. A little bit. Gradius, depends on who you say, how you say it. So I enjoyed it. Here's another rhythm game that I played. It was just basically the whole time you're playing, it's rhythm. And from there, you just enjoy, you know, what you're doing. It was a lot of fun, I will say. It was Japanese music I've never heard before. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much the end of the video. It is $8 for 1 hour and $18 for the whole day. And I hope you enjoyed. I'll catch you in the next video.
Linda the Gamer Girl. She's here, she's playing games. Linda the Gamer Girl. She's here, she's playing games today.